All right, in this video, we're going to go over the company preferences. And something to keep in mind, similar to what I said in the last video, is that when I go through these preferences, it's not so that you can be an expert at preferences. It's just so that you can keep in mind, in the back of your mind, that QuickBooks has the ability to open up these functions, okay? So we go up under Edit, down to Preferences. And we're going to start with accounting, company preferences. If you want to use account numbers, you can check this off here. If you ever come in and want to turn account numbers off for a while, let's say you hire a new bookkeeper and they don't like using them, you can come in and turn them off, uncheck it. That doesn't delete account numbers anywhere. It just hides the field so that you don't see the field anymore. Okay. Now, if you want to show only the lowest subaccount on reports, you can check that off. All right, if you want to require accounts, QuickBooks is a double-sided financial software, so even if you don't require an account, it's going to put it somewhere. It's going to put the other side of the transaction somewhere, the debit and the credit, and it's usually going to go to an uncategorized. All right, do you use classes? Do you want to prompt to assign classes? Do you want to automatically assign the journal entry numbers? Do you want to warn when you post a transaction to retain earnings? And that's not just for you, this is across the board because it's company preferences. So everyone will be warned if they post a transaction to retained earnings. Do you want to have date warnings if the transactions are more than 90 days in the past, more than 30 days in the future? These are great, especially at year end, right? Because you get so used to entering 12/31, say it's January 1st, 2012, you enter 12/31, it's going to default to 12/31/2012. Instead of 2011, which is what you really meant. Okay, so warn if it's more than 30 days in the future, more than 90 days in the past, and also where you come in and set your closing date and password. On the bills, this is for default. Bills are defaulted to be due 45 days after receipt. Again, you can change that on the bill. This is just going to be the default. And if you want to warn about duplicate bill numbers, you can check that here. When you are paying bills, do you want to automatically use credits? So have credits automatically applied to the bills. It's going to be based on the aging. And do you automatically want to use discounts? And what's the default discount account that you want those discounts to go to? All right. And on these automatically use discounts, that's for if you get, you know, 2%, 10, net 30. So that automatic 2% discount that you get for paying within 10 days, that's that discount I was talking about there. All right, company preferences for checking. Do you want to print the account names on the voucher check? So if you pay a vendor for services and items, you can have that broken out. Whenever you have a check, when you reprint a check, do you want to change the check date to the current date? One of these, I had a client, now it did change to non-cleared check as printed, but I did have a client once that we were going through an audit, and so they had to go through and print a whole bunch of checks, reprint a whole bunch of checks just to show to the auditor, and when they did that, this preference was checked, and the dates changed all to the current date, so it all changed to today's date. And of course, going back and fixing all of those, first going in and printing all of them is a pain, but then going back and fixing them to the right date is a pain too. On a check, if you want to start with the payee field, check this off. So what that means, I like this little preference. In writing checks, instead of starting up here under bank account number or bank account, it'll start the tab here. Okay. All right. Do you want to warn about duplicate check numbers? And do you want to autofill the payee account number in the memo? Okay, so based on like when you're paying a vendor, if you have an account number filled in on that vendor's card, then it'll autofill the memo with that vendor number or print out on a check. Okay, so default accounts for create paychecks and payroll liabilities, where you're paying from. Again, this is default. And then how you want to do your online banking in a side-by-side mode or in a register mode. And we talk about that in another video. On your desktop, do you use sales receipts, yes or no? If no, you uncheck this, and it comes off of your home screen. So if I look at home now, no sales receipts. Okay, so as a way to kind of clean up your home screen here, that's a, you know, use your preferences to clean those up. All right, and then also estimates, sales orders. If you don't use any of these features, you can go in there and turn them off so that they don't show up on this home screen. All right, finance charges. What's the annual interest rate? Again, notice it's annually. So if you want to charge 1% per month, you want to put this as 12%. The minimum finance charge. So let's say you don't want to create an invoice for $5. We want to say don't create a finance charge unless a finance charge invoice unless it's going to be at least $20 or at least $100, whatever it is that you want to have in there. Do you want to add a grace period? So if it's net 30, but you add a grace period of 15 days, so if they pay within 45 days, they don't get this finance charge added to them. What's the finance charge account? Where does it get charged to? Do you assess finance charges on overdue finance charges? So if you have this $20 finance charge assessed and then next month you go to assess finance charges again, do you want to assess it on this $20 from last month as well? Do you calculate charges from the due date or from the original invoice date? And do you want to mark finance charge invoices automatically to be printed so that when you go in and create them once a month, you can mass print them out? Okay. Under general, how do you like your hours being shown? Do you like them as decimals, 10.2, or as minutes, 10 and 12 seconds, or 12 minutes? Do you want to show years in four digits or two digits? Do you want to update name information when saving transactions? So if you change something in the customer center or if you change something on an invoice, do you want it to update the customer's V-card? Usually I say never. Okay. Do you want to save transactions before printing? Probably a good idea. So you don't want to print out a check and then accidentally push the clear button and not save it. All right, integrated applications. These are applications that have access to your QuickBooks file. So you see here, Intuit automatically sets up for you the, you know, sync manager, the financial statement designer, fixed asset manager, all these different things that have access. But if you have additional third-party add-ons like AIA building, field service management, different things like this, you can come in here and look at the applications that have access to your QuickBooks file. If you're canceling services, so if you're no longer using a certain add-on, you can come in here and uncheck that and or remove it from this list of programs that can have access to your file. Okay. Do you use inventory? Yes, and purchase orders. So you check this if your inventory to turn on purchase orders and inventory. Do you want to warn about duplicate purchase order numbers? Probably a smart idea. So if you know you have in your purchasing department several people, you want to make sure that they don't use the same purchase order number. Do you want, when you're calculating quantity available, so in QuickBooks, you know, you have your on-hand quantity and then your quantity available. Do you want to deduct quantity reserved for pending build and quantity reserved for sales orders from that available quantity? So I have 100 on hand, but I've got 10 out on a sales order and I got 10 out on builds. So I really only have 80 available. That's what it's asking. Do you want to have only 80 available or do you want to just keep it at that 100? Do you want to receive a warning if there's not enough inventory on hand to sell? And do you want to get the warning when it exceeds the quantity available or the warning when it exceeds the quantity on hand? All right. And units of measure, do you use multiple units of measure or single units of measure or is this disabled? Jobs and estimates, your different statuses of jobs, the different progress levels of jobs. You can change these, the verbiage here. All right. Do you create estimates? Yes or no. Do you do progress invoicing? Yes or no. Do you want to warn about duplicate estimate numbers? Again, same thing. Leave that on because you can go in there and create an estimate. And Joe can go in there and create an estimate. And you haven't saved them. Neither of you saved them. And then Joe saves his. So it gets that estimate number. And then you go to save yours. And if you check this box, what it's going to do is it's going to say, hey, somebody else already saved something with this estimate number. Do you want to use the next one? So you say yes. Okay. And if you don't want to print items that have zero amount, you can check that off too. Here you can turn on multiple currencies. We go through that in another video. Here we'd go through payments. So do you accept credit cards through QuickBooks? Do you do e-check processing, paper check processing, e-check processing? When you receive payments, do you want to automatically apply the payments to whatever open invoices are in there? Or do you want to automatically calculate payments? So if you uncheck this box and you go into customer receive payments, and we're going to say this guy. So if you uncheck this box, you try and click off, oh, they paid this one. Wait a second. It gives you a warning because it says you can't apply an amount greater than the total payment. So what you have to do is you have to come in here and put in there 5019.08, and then it'll allow you to check this off. Okay. If you go into preferences and turn that on, okay, then you go to customers, receive payments, and we're going to receive from Christy again, and it lets me calculate, and then it counts that up for you up there. Okay, so just a quick little tip. If you want to use the undeposited funds as a default deposit to account, it's a good thing to do because then you can receive all your payments and then make one giant deposit in the bank. If you are using the Intuit payment network to allow clients to pay online, and we go through this in another video, but do you want that payment link to be shown on invoices that are emailed? Do you want that payment link to be shown on printed invoices? What is your email address through your Intuit payment network? Okay. Payroll employees, do you have full payroll, no payroll, or complete payroll, which is being phased out? You can go through your preferences for pay stub and voucher printing, workers' comp, sick, vacation. All of these preferences we go through in the payroll videos. Copy earning details from previous paychecks, so it automatically pulls up the previous paycheck information. Recall hour field on paychecks. Recall quantity field on paychecks. Do job costing on a per item basis. Display employee name list by first name. Mark employees as sales reps. Display social security numbers. Okay, all these different preferences on payroll. We go into these more in depth, though, in the payroll video. All right, your reminders. Which reminders do you want to show? Or which reminders do you want to show on the reminders list? This is for everyone, remember, not just mine. This is company preferences, which reminders. Reports and graphs. Do we run reports on an accrual basis as a default or cash? Do we do the aging as of the due date or as of the transaction date? Do you want to show the name on reports or name and description or description only? And that's meaning the description on the item. So you have your item name, item description, chart of accounts name, chart of accounts description. So that's what I was talking about there. Your statement of cash flows, you come in here and set that up. This is not an operating, this is an investing, you know, whatever it is. So you can classify the accounts properly. QuickBooks sets it as a default, but they might be incorrect because they don't know exactly all of what these accounts are when you set them up, where they need to fall. All right. And then also, if you want to set up the formats for the reports across the board, so instead of saying Rock Castle Construction, you want to say RCC Inc., you can change that, mass change that on all reports. If you want to have on the extra footer line for management purposes only, so that's printed out on all reports. Okay, if you want report numbers, anything like that to be shown in here. And then also fonts, if you want reports to print out larger, you can come in here and mass change the fonts, the default fonts. Okay. Sales and customers. All right, sales forms, what's the usual shipping method? So the default shipping method. What's the usual freight on board method, FOB? Do you want to warn about duplicate invoice numbers? Do you use price levels? Do you use sales orders? Warn about duplicate sales order numbers. Don't print items with zero amounts when converting to an invoice. So from a sales order to invoice, don't print zero amounts. What's the template you want to use for a packing slip? What's the template you want to use for a pick list? And the again, what's the template for invoicing packing slips? So this is doing a packing slip from an invoice versus doing a packing slip from a sales order. Okay. Sales tax. Whoops. Sales tax. You charge sales tax. Yes. What's your most common sales tax item? That means it's going to default to that item all the time. What are your different taxable codes? Taxable, non-taxable, non-taxable. Do you want that T to print out on an invoice when things are taxable? So what that means is if I come in here and look at an invoice, okay, and it's taxable. So when I go to print preview, see that little T on the side? So that shows up there as T if it's taxable. Okay. A lot of people wonder, you know, well, are my services taxable? I know you should be taxing my product purchases, but my services shouldn't be taxable. So that lets them know with that little T that yes, the product was taxed, services, there's no T. Okay. When do you owe sales tax? As of the invoice date? Are you paying on an accrual basis or cash basis? So as an invoice date or upon receipt of payment? When do you pay sales tax? Monthly, quarterly, annually? Okay. Your search setup, company preferences, how often do you want to update the search? So you can automatically run it every 60 minutes, every 5 minutes, whatever you want to do. Of course, the more frequently you run that, the more it bogs down your system, slows you down a little bit. With that, you might want to not automatically update it because you can come in here and update search information automatically anytime you use it. So if you're not using it that frequently, maybe you just want to manually do it. All right. So you can update your search information from here. And how many results per page do you want to show when you do a search? Okay. With send forms, what's the default information you want sent in the template for invoices? Do you automatically want to BCC someone, maybe yourself? What do you want in the subject line? Okay, so you can do that for invoices, estimates, all these different things. And again, this is just the default that comes up, pulls up. This way you can automate what your employees are sending out to customers, vendors, etc. You can make it automatic so they don't have to worry about filling in any information. The service connection. How do you want to handle your connection to QuickBooks services? Automatically connect without asking for a password, or always ask for a password when connecting. And do you want to allow for background downloading of service messages? So payroll connections, except payroll and online banking. So you have to put in your password, right? Because those are sensitive areas of the business. But if you have any other services that connect down to QuickBooks, then you can, you know, set those to automatically connect or to ask for a password. Okay. Spelling, there's no company preferences there. It's all only my preferences. Your 1099s, this is where you get them set up, and we have another video on this, but this is, you know, do you file 1099s, yes or no? What are the accounts that rents fall into? So probably down here under rent. Okay. Threshold of $600. That's a default. You can change it if you need to. All right. And of course you can select multiple on these too. So if there's, you know, for the non-employee compensation, it's not just subs. It is multiple accounts. It is, accounting fees. It is legal fees. It is outside contract services, and it's subs, right? Okay. Time and expenses. Do you track time? Yes. What's the first day of your work week? So let's say Sunday is the first day of your work week. We can change that up. Do you create invoices from a list of time and expenses? Yes or no? So you can check that off if you do. If you bill directly for your employee time, if you don't bill directly, you can come in here and turn that off. Do you track reimbursed expenses as income? And what's the default markup? And what's the default markup account? Okay. So again, a lot of information in these preferences, but now you've got it in the back of your mind in case anybody ever comes to you and asks you to set things up the right way in QuickBooks.